secondary. It turned out not to be an issue at all, though. Don Carey returned and Eddie Lacy fumbled for a touchdown while the Lions held Green Bay to 223 yards of offense and sacked that bad man twice in the 19-7 loss.
What's it mean to beat them today?
It means a lot. Divisional games are always important. The biggest thing we talked about is getting off to the right start in our division. We're going to see this team last game of the season, I'm sure, is going to have a big meaning. And we just wanted to dominate and get started on the right foot. Hopefully, this game kind of sets the tone for the rest of the division. Obviously, you know, we set out every year to win a division. This is a good start for us.
All right. It's a good start for them. Their defense was awesome, so says Reggie Bush. Let's talk about Aaron Rodgers and the Packers. How concerned are you for them, Stephen A?
I'm incredibly concerned. Skip Bayless, the bad man that he is, has appeared to be anything but. He hasn't been too impressive, to say the least. Yesterday, just 162 yards passing, a relatively pedestrian performance, albeit the front four for the Detroit Lions was suffocating them. They were in his face all day long. They were making things incredibly inconvenient for him. And they knew that they had to because Detroit's secondary was decimated. And the only way they were going to neutralize Green Bay was to make sure they got constant pressure on Aaron Rodgers all day long. But Starks and Eddie Lacy combining for 74 yards rushing on 19 carries did not help matters. Jordy Nelson and Randall Cobb and the crew being relatively neutralized. Obviously, Aaron Rodgers' protection had something to do with it. But I call him the bad man, not just because of that rifle arm of his, that pinpoint passing that he's able to exhibit, but also his athleticism, his ability to be evasive and scramble out of the pocket and make plays, whether it be with his legs literally running or scrambling out of the pocket and creating time so receivers could get open. I'm not seeing that Aaron Rodgers in two of the first three games of this NFL season. They seem incredibly unimpressive. And for the defense to force three turnovers and to hold Detroit's high-powered offense to just 10 points, but somehow, some way, Green Bay still can't find a way to win this game. I'm going to put most of that onus right where it belongs, on Aaron Rodgers and Coach Mike McCarthy. They don't seem to be clicking right now. Something's awry. Something's amiss. Guys that know far more about football than me, the aficionados I'm talking about, can dissect it a hell of a lot better than I'll even try to. But in the end, I'm not liking what I'm seeing. And I watched this game yesterday as well. I'm not impressed at all.
Wow. You know, I'm so with you, I can't even joke about this anymore. Because the bad man that is Aaron Rodgers was once again just bad yesterday by his standards. He was great late against the Jets. But this is Aaron Rodgers against a division opponent in a dome he has owned in the past. And that's all you got? And I just don't get it. I don't. Was he under duress much of the day? Yeah, he was. Then I think sometimes he looks too much to Jordy Nelson, who's obviously a sensational receiver. But then I look at the targets. Jordy had 7 targets, but Cobb had 6. Corliss had 5. I don't know. I don't think he's completely going Jordy Nelson crazy here. As you point out, they really couldn't run the ball much. I mean, it's not bad to have 76 yards. It's not 26 yards, like a lot of teams wound up with
combined
yesterday. Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. It's not terrible. But remember, Detroit even gave them the football.
Yeah.
Green Bay won the turnover battle 3-1. So here. Matt Stafford fumbled down near the goal line. I'm saying, what are you doing? You got him on the ropes and you let him back, give him some new life, and they couldn't take advantage. And Aaron Rodgers was just mostly off all day. So I don't know. How do you explain this, Stephen A? Is he in a slump? Is he distracted? Healthy? I don't know.
Seems a bit distracted. Doesn't seem to be himself. You listen to guys that cover the NFL, they'll tell you that Mike McCarthy is not too hard to figure out. I don't know if that's fair to McCarthy. The man is a good coach. He's proven to be a good coach. He's a Super Bowl championship coach. I think he deserves all of our respect. But at the same time, when you look at Aaron Rodgers and the regression that appears to be taking place, if he's healthy and the skill set is there, but something's not happening, could it be injuries? Could it be that the offensive line is highly suspect?
Maybe.
Because it's not just that he's not throwing the football effectively. They're not running the football effectively, and I have no choice but to at least think about the offensive line under those circumstances, because usually when your offensive line is right and tight, one of those things are working for you. You're either running the football effectively or throwing the football effectively. When you're not doing either particularly well, then I have to look at the level of protection that guys are getting and say, well, that would make sense. But still in all, regardless of the circumstances, I expect more from Aaron Rodgers.
Yeah, I do too.
And this is the first time that the Detroit Lions haven't been able to beat a fully healthy Aaron Rodgers.
That's right.
In uniform.
Yep.
This is the first time they've been able to beat him.